Is it as simple as that? Is it just public services you're looking for?
No, unfortunately, this government has proven themselves to be extremely anti-rural by their actions over the last 4.5 years. That's a fact. That's a matter of fact. If they want to, even at this late stage, try to put a mark and try to do something meaningful to help sustain rural Ireland, there are a number of things that they should be doing. First of all, with much fanfare, they picked, well, a very good man, a man that I admire and I like, Pat Spillane, to head up the Central report. But when he brought forward that report, it was left gathering dust for an awful long time. The only time they picked it up and decided to look at it and do something about it was when he came out publicly in the media and attacked them for what they were doing and the fact that they were giving no notice whatsoever to the work.
But what was his silver bullet?
Well, you see, his Noel, it wasn't just one silver bullet. He had a number of recommendations. Now, the response and the money that the government has put following the Central report and its recommendations is negligible, and they're not acting upon the report. If they wanted to set up a meeting...
But they made Anne Phelan minister for...
Yes, and look, I have no problem. Anne Phelan is a very good minister, but the only thing about it is, and she admitted it herself in recent days, that she's afraid that a lot of her senior colleagues in government aren't actually taking any notice of what she's doing, what she's trying to do. Because remember, this is the government.
You see,
who did away and abolished it?
Okay.
Our town council.
Okay, sir, can I try to bring it up to you? Because you're all coming from the same perspective. Could I put it to you? If we were having this discussion in the north of England or in Wales, the very same thing would apply. Look, my point is, I'm very empathetic to what you're saying, but let's be real. If you're Mr. Google and you're going to come to Ireland, and you don't have to come to Ireland, you're going to go to where there's the best infrastructure. You're going to go to where if I have a heart attack, I'll get treated best. I'm going to go to the best airport to get in and out. I want my kids to go to the best university. Is there not, coming out of the recession, in every developed country, a urbanisation, a flight to quality of life, and a flight to cities? And actually what we need to do is spend money on schools that there aren't places available in West Dublin, where there's housinglessness and a homeless crisis in our cities. Instead of giving you more money, actually put it to where the people are going.
Well, the first part I absolutely agree with. All developed countries have that. And in fact, tonight on RTÉ, they're repeating the Rural Ireland documentary Richard Curran did, which is fantastic. I think many must have seen it before. And that was stated, this is happening everywhere. And these are the dynamics. Nevertheless, the second part I don't agree with. I think, like, Dublin, the population exploded. We're going to go rise by 600,000 people by
the next
whatever. 400,000 are in Dublin.
Inside
Dublin
the
is too big. It's unmanageable. We had Conor Fulton on this station earlier on talking about traffic. I mean, and he's fighting to prevent traffic calming measures, modest ones in my opinion, at the centre of the city. The belt around Dublin, it's all weighted towards Dublin. We need
but
to break up.
Same
and
in London.
I know, in a way, the opportunity's been lost because what the documentary was a spatial strategy report was thrown in the bin. The Buchanan report back in the 80s and 90s. I mean, this is something stuff that I wasn't pretty aware of.
But so you cannot tell Google to go to Ballymore.
Yeah, but you have to.
And you shouldn't expect them to go to
Ballymore. But there are multinationals in Athlone, there are in Ballinasloe, in Ballyhonus, there are places, you know, that, like, they don't all have to come to Dublin, you know.
Okay, well, let me put it another way to you. The business in rural land is predominantly agriculture and tourism.
Hold on now, how come we had Uber coming to Limerick then only last week with 300 jobs?
That's Limerick City.
Yeah, but look,
I'm talking about cities.
Up here in Dublin, people look on rural Ireland as everywhere outside the M50.
No, that's a fair point, but the point I'm making is there is a migration towards cities where they have critical mass.
No, you're absolutely correct, Ivan, but I think what you're advocating here is a one-size-fits-all. And that is never going to happen. You can't expect that every town and village throughout the country will have the same services and facilities and infrastructure and employment. Effectively, what they need to do is concentrate on their key assets. And the community living in those areas are the best people that knows them. They need to capitalise on those assets in terms of moving forward. So you can't expect that every single town and village throughout the country is going to have a technological firm supporting growth. They need to, I suppose, get up and realise that they...
You're peddling false hope.
No, Ivan, you're absolutely wrong. And you know, you really are way off map in this whole debate. And I'll tell you why. If we were to listen to you here now tonight, what we'd actually do is get the key of rural Ireland and throw it away. I'll give you examples of how rural Ireland is fighting back. For instance, in Causeway in County Kerry, there's a family business, Dairy Master, employing nearly 400 people. A family business. Now, this is a state-of-the-art business where they're exporting their goods all around the world, to every part of the world, from Causeway. Then we have places like Fixico and Culloden employing enormous amounts of people, giving great good jobs. So you're wrong, and people want to leave places like that.
My general point is this, Alan, I'd like you to take that. I know a little bit about agriculture, and what's going to happen in agriculture is, with the abolition of milk quotas, you've got to be competitive, and that means scale. So average farm sizes are going to go from 40 acres to 120 acres. You're going to see six-wheel big tractors driving through the village because of efficiency. So that's the future of agriculture. Yes, there'll be processing jobs, but is there not a reality that you're trying to let kink in you just to keep back the tide? It's inevitable. What's that?
It's not inevitable at all. Like I said, look, people are moving back to towns of a certain size. But what we haven't mentioned, and the government doesn't get credit for it normally, and leader programme, you hear about the leader programme. You don't hear about the local and community development programme. It delivered 5,000 jobs to people who wanted to set up a hairdresser's, a dog grooming salon, small jobs. You know what?
These aren't cutting nettles, community employment schemes.
No, they're real jobs. And in Donegal, like, we had the figures. After 3 years, 60%. After 3 years, 60% of those jobs.
Absolutely. I think, Michael, both of you are right, actually. I think that's where this is the other contrast. Small, niche things in food production and in tourism. Every town in Ireland, we've got fantastic country tourism. This is the best year ever for tourism, and they're not all staying in Dublin and Trinity College.
Can we not learn by other people's mistakes? Over in England, they closed down 10,000 post offices. They regret that now. We have an opportunity to sustain our network here if what we need, quite simply, is government backing. Recently, our Minister for Social Protection sent out notifications to everybody that was receiving their welfare payments that they should receive them through the banks. What way is she supporting?
As always, Michael Healy Rae gets the last word. Like, thank one and all. As you can see, there is plenty of hope for rural Ireland. They ain't thrown in the towel yet. After the break, thank you one and all. After the break, we'll take a preview of tomorrow morning's.